Today's video is titled Isms, for the suffix or the end of the word that ends in ism. You'll be learning about words that end in ism. This will be helpful for era 8, 1900 to 1950. So ism, the suffix or the end part of the word, means a belief, theory, or practice. For example, here's a negative example. But racism is the belief that each race has specific abilities. Capitalism is one that you'll be learning about today. It's a belief or a focus or a practice on using money or capital and trading money and property. An ist is means one who. So some examples, a racist is a person who believes one race is superior to others. A capitalist is a wealthy person who invests money into industry to make more money. An artist is one who does art. The four isms you'll learn today are capitalism, socialism, we'll review nationalism, and imperialism. So capitalism is an economic system, so it's a system of trading money, and it means that a group or individual can produce things to sell. So before that, there was feudalism, back in the medieval times, where kings ruled the empire, lords owned the land in the empire, lesser lords managed parts of the land that the lords owned. Knights protected to get a piece of land, and serfs did all of the work for a very small part of land. But eventually, capitalism came about. So people could decide what product or service they can sell, they can decide how much it costs, they can make a lot of money if they're selling something that's popular. Socialism is also an economic system. It's where a collective, a large group of people, or the government produces goods and services. So the government would control the production, as opposed to in capitalism, where it might be a person or a company that controls the production. So would the US be capitalist or socialist? You could argue it's a mix of both. People and companies create their own products and they profit. For example, Steve Jobs made lots of money with Apple and many of its products. But the government also produces products or services like public education, public libraries, public fire departments, public police departments, anything that you pay taxes to support, the military. Nationalism, we've learned a little bit about nationalism, but we know it's the loyalty or devotion to a nation or country, but it's also that you promote that country's interests or culture. And it means that you put your country above all other countries. Imperialism is the practice of extending a nation's power over other territories. So, for example, British imperialism created the enormous British Empire. So it spread its rule beyond its country. Imperialism would be taking the rules and what your country does and kind of sending them to somewhere else, or it's not as nice as sending them, but putting them somewhere else beyond and outside of that country. I'm going to give you a bonus ism. It's fascism. Don't get too excited because it's not that great. This kind of like nationalism, where you put your country above another country in nationalism, this puts the country above the person. So instead of the person having the rights, the nation is what has the rights first and foremost. So the nation and the government makes all of the decisions. And you're expected to do what is best for the nation, not for yourself. This can get where government is controlling a lot. It's controlling everything within people's lives. It's very regimented. And if people are opposed to that, if people are opposed or there's opposition where people are arguing out against the government, that is suppressed and sometimes very violently, or you're locked in prison. So from where we are, fascism can be very, very have a negative idea.